February, almost Christmas. We have had a great few weeks in our Christmas series, and it's all coming to an end today.
We're super excited because Matt Keeney, our transit director, is here for our last conversation of the year. Check it out.
There is nothing better than feeling like you have someone in your life who gets you. No matter what you're dealing with or going through or feeling, it's always better when there is someone by your side. We all want to be around people who can make us laugh, someone who smiles when they see us, who will text us, who will like all of our Instagram pics. But when it comes to friendship, I'm guessing you're looking for something on a deeper level. Beyond the fun and games and likes, you probably wish you had a friend who could always relate to you and understand exactly what you feel. Someone who knows your story, even the embarrassing parts, and loves you anyway. Someone who knows you better than you know yourself, a real, authentic, forever kind of friend. Every friendship has its limits though, doesn't it? I mean, no one will be able to understand you all the time. Your best friend, no matter how late into the night you guys talk and tell stories, will never know every detail of your life or your history. If you're lucky, you can find someone whose loyalty towards you is pretty unshakable, no matter what. But guys, we're all human, aren't we? Even the very best friend can't be a perfect friend. So, what does friendship have to do with Christmas? Well, let's look at the beginning of the story of the very first Christmas, the day that Jesus was born. In the book of Matthew, one of the books that tells us about the life of Jesus, it talks about how the birth of Jesus, all this took place to fulfill what the Lord had said to the prophet. And here's what it says. The virgin will conceive and give birth to a son, and they will call him Emmanuel, which means God with us. God with us. That's the good news of Christmas, is that God has always been with us. He has been with us since the beginning, and he has never gone away. But here's the problem. We can't see him, we can't touch him, we can't hear him. Sometimes that makes him feel distant and silent and far away. But guys, that's not the kind of relationship God wants with us. He wants something closer. He wants a friendship. So he, Jesus, came to earth to be with us, to hang out with us, to eat with us, to walk with us, to know exactly what it was like to be one of us. Jesus came to be fully human, just like you and me. This is a big deal. It means that Jesus knows exactly what it's like to be a person like you and me. He knows what it's like to live in this world, to breathe, to eat, to get sick, to do chores, to obey his parents and grow up and eventually have to find a job, to make friends and to lose friends, to be mistreated and misunderstood. He knows what it's like to be lonely, to be disappointed, to be frustrated, to be afraid. He knows what it's like to feel left out, to be made fun of, to feel like he didn't measure up. Jesus knows every thought and emotion you've had and that you felt. Not just because he's God and he can read your mind, but because he's felt and experienced all of those things personally. Jesus knows exactly what it's like to be you, and that makes Jesus not a far-off God who can't be bothered with you, but a best friend who wants to be close to you. I know over the next few days, a lot of our focus is going to shift from Emmanuel to what we're getting ready for Christmas. And that's totally fine and normal. I hope we all get some great gifts this Christmas. But my hope is that in the middle of thinking about what we're going to get, we don't forget what we already have. You have the greatest gift available to you. In Jesus, you have a God who has not only rescued you, but a God who is with you. Jesus gets you. And that unexpected gift is all we really need.
Hey, we could sing a song with my shirt. And you have lights.
Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Do y'all want to see this dance move real fast? I don't want to bother anybody. This is a squirrel on a skateboard.
What are we doing here?
All right, I'm ready. Hey y'all, happy almost merry. Okay. Not the cross my arms.
No, because the gorilla.
Because the gorilla.
Matt Keeney's gonna be up with our last conversation of 2020.
Ooh, that was kind of clean.
Did you like that? Clean. 2020?
I feel like we're good now.
I like hearing the jabs.
Stop it.
2020.
Comment down below if you liked that.